News at 4 starts right now.
With First Alert Weather, this is WKYT News.
And good afternoon. A lot going on. Severe weather has been rolling through the region on this primary election day. Our viewers have been sending us pictures and video of the storms that have already hit our region.
Yeah, take a look. This video comes into us from Braden, Delaware in Richmond. You can see those thick clouds there gathering in the sky, getting very close to what looks like forming a tornado. Let's get you right over to WKYT Chief Meteorologist Chris Bailey on this First Alert Weather Day.
Yeah, guys, every bit as busy as we anticipated yesterday, and highlighting the southern half of Kentucky on this WKYT First Alert Weather Day. Good news, for the first time in a little more than 2 hours, we have no active tornado warnings. We have numerous counties, though, that are under severe thunderstorm warnings into the southeastern corner of the state. Take a look at the map. The current warnings that are out showing up in yellow, and you notice across the far southeast, we're not seeing that as much of a line as what we were dealing with a little bit ago. Severe thunderstorm watch until 8 o'clock is primarily across the south and southeast. This thing is going to likely be canceled within the next 1 to 2 hours, because by then, by between 5 and 6, those storms across the southeast are out of Kentucky. Now, we're still on guard for the potential for some of these storms to spin into southeastern Kentucky. As of right now, we have severe thunderstorm warnings with a severe thunderstorm that is right on top of Corbin, north of London, into southern parts of the Jackson County area, that is around Anvil, heading over into northern sections of Clay County. And from there, a separate thunderstorm, I think this is the strongest that we're dealing with on the entire map right now, that is on top of Buckhorn into Perry County. That is going to roll its way to the east, likely large hail and damaging winds with that particular storm. There's another intense thunderstorm, southern parts of Magoffin County, heading toward downtown Prestonsburg. You can see that storm that is working its way through. We're also watching this particular supercell thunderstorm that has weakened considerably. This is the one that, when it was developing to the northwest of Richmond, we went and looked inside that storm before any warning came out, and we found rotation with that. And then a few minutes, we had a tornado warning out for that. So we were giving you advance notice on that, and it is still going strong into Campton toward Hazel Green, going to pass between Sagersville and West Liberty in the southern parts of Morgan County. It's going to roll its way toward the east from Owingsville back toward Mount Sterling, general showers and thunderstorms, Richmond, Lexington, Nicholasville, Georgetown, Frankfort. We can breathe a sigh of relief. There's nothing out there. Things are all clear as of right now. That is certainly some welcome news. But you can see how this line of thunderstorms is continuing to progress toward southern and southeastern parts of the Bluegrass State. Damaging winds, large hail threat, going to continue for about the next hour or so. Lightning is increasing with that. I'm going to watch for some pockets of flash flooding into southeastern Kentucky as well, because, of course, we needed another thing to worry about. But the possibility is there for some high water issues to develop with some of these storms that move over the same areas a couple of times in a row into the southeastern corner of the state. So guys, as of right now, severe thunderstorm warnings are out. Obviously, we're going to be weather heavy coming up here in the next little bit until we get rid of these storms. If we pop another tornado warning, or if we get any more damage picks or information, we're going to break in and let you know immediately.
All right, Chris, you let us know. Thank you. And you will notice there on the bottom left hand of your screen, there is a QR code. It's going to take you directly to our WKYT First Alert Weather app that you can download for free. We have been following this severe weather really all afternoon long here.
Let's go check it out, see what we see out there. WKYT's Grayson Passmore is tracking the conditions, and she's joining us now live in Madison County, where there were several warnings this afternoon. Grayson?
Yeah, guys, we are here in Richmond now, just off of the 75 exit. We, of course, traveled southbound on 75 to get here from Lexington. That entire ride here was a lot of just steady rain that entire time. It was also a lot of steady and pretty heavy traffic. About when we hit mile marker 97, that's when we first started to really hit a lot of traffic. A lot of cars were slowing down. It just seemed like a big slowdown from what we could tell, people probably trying to be very careful because the roads, of course, were very slick. Now, when we were traveling down here, we did see a northbound direction. We saw one car that appeared to maybe have just slipped off the road. It was getting taken out of the little ditch area by a tow truck at that point. So it was probably a good idea of all the cars just going very slow, drivers being extra cautious right now. We did also get some pictures sent in by you guys at home. Go ahead and take a look at your screen and get a good look at these for yourself. We've seen viewers send us these pictures of dark storm clouds that moved over parts of Richmond since we've been out here. The rain seems to have subsided just a little bit, but we are hearing still a little bit of thunder since we first got out here, just in the distance in our area right here. Now, we haven't gotten any reports of damage in this area besides a tree down, but thankfully no structural damage so far. We, of course, are still checking with all of our emergency management agencies, and just we will bring you guys reports of any damage and just any more weather reports. Just stay tuned with us. Live in Richmond, Grayson Passmore, WKYG.
Grayson, thank you. We're getting some power outage reports now coming out of Rockcastle County. Jackson Energy says about 2,500 customers are without power. Storms went through that area, impacted the Broadhead substations. Crews are working as quickly as they can to try and restore power. And again, stay weather aware with the First Alert Weather app. You can download it by scanning this QR code, or you can search for it in the app or Google Play stores. And with that app, you're going to get the latest weather alerts and radar. And even if you were to lose power, that app is still going to work with cellular data to keep you in the know.
And again, we'll keep you in the know. If we get any updates, we'll pass it on. Today, of course, the weather and the election, they're kind of competing for attention. Voters are heading to the polls today for Kentucky's primary election. The biggest decision on the ballot, the race for the Republican nomination for governor.
And following 3 days of early voting, polls opened at 6 o'clock this morning here in Fayette County. Officials say as of 1:30 this afternoon, nearly 19,000 people had voted. That puts turnout in Lexington around 8%. The county clerk's office is reporting no issues at the polls so far.
The Republican candidates for governor also have been casting their ballots today.
WKYT's Destiny Quinn is in studio now.
Rumble into southeastern Kentucky. They'll be out of the state very soon. Our First Alert Weather Day. Well, the hours on that are numbered. We'll track it this month.
First Alert Traffic, only on WKYT, brought to you by Morgan and...
Hi everybody, we continue with the WKYT First Alert Weather Day for just a little bit longer, and by 6 o'clock tonight, not only are the polls closing across Kentucky, but we're in all likelihood going to be able to say goodbye First Alert Weather Day. Right now, we say hello to 9 different sky cams from across central and eastern Kentucky, where you've got cloudy skies. We've got some showers, thunderstorms that are targeting the south and southeast. That has been the trend for a little while now, and that continues to be the trend. Okay, newly issued tornado warning that is out now into southern parts of Magoffin County. So that just coming in. So now we're looking at a newly issued tornado warning that is out into the southern part of Magoffin County. That, my friends, is with the same storm that we have been tracking for a while, that supercell thunderstorm into Magoffin County. And that's the same one that blew up over top of Madison County. So we're looking at this, and it is across the southern part of Magoffin County. That includes the Royalton area. What we can do with this is that storm is zipping through very, very quickly. But on the southern edge of this, there is a little bit of some spin showing up. And there you go. That is right on top of Route 30. And that's toward the Middle Fork area. That goes over toward Rusaw into Breathitt County. So here is our spin that is on top of Route 30. This is going to be heading toward the Royalton area through Oakley, through Carver, and that will make its way into the eastern part of Magoffin County coming up over the next little bit. Far western sections of Floyd County, we are included in that. But this is a spin that is just developing. And again, that is right on top of Route 30. That's very close to the old Middle Fork Elementary School into the southwestern parts of Magoffin County. And that's going to continue to work its way toward the east. So if you're watching us right now, Oakley, toward Carver, into close to the Tip Top area, Royalton, that is with a tornado warning that is heading in your general direction as of right now. The radar showing that particular spin, and we can go up close and personal. So there's 4 Acre, there's, you see Carver, we just mentioned Tip Top, we're on the southern side of that. But eventually, this spin is going to be working its way toward Royalton and Route 7. So here's downtown Sayersville. This is Route 7, Mason, getting toward Royalton, and then the Carver and Oakley areas would be in this general area. So we're watching that center of circulation, the spin, not center of circulation, but the spin with this, the couplet is right on top of Route 30. So the Mountain Parkway is right here, and this is where you would get off from the Mountain Parkway on Route 30, the Middle Fork area, and that spin between 4 Acre and Sites and toward the Mountain Parkway. So essentially, we're looking at an area south of Salyersville. This would be approximately 5 miles to the south of where that devastating 2012 tornado tracked through Salyersville and into Johnson County. This one holding together would be toward Royalton in just a matter of a couple of minutes. Ivington were included in that. And again, this would go toward the Floyd County line. But we're watching this storm. It has been amazing to watch this same supercell thunderstorm pulsing up, and it's doing it one last time here into Magoffin County with that tornado warning that is out. So here is Royalton. This is downtown Salyersville. We may be getting some large hail here on the northern extent of that, but that is over toward the old Middle Fork Elementary School there on Route 30, and that's going to continue to roll its way to the east very, very quickly with that tornado warning that is out for just Magoffin County and part of Floyd County. There you see it gets into an extreme southern section of Johnson County, too. That goes until 5:15, so we got about a 25-minute lifespan on that particular storm. So the southern edge of this is going to work its way. Our tornado is right on top of the 4-acre area. That is going to head toward the east. You can see the right-hand fork of Oakley here, where we're talking about River Road. It's going to essentially be working right across the Licking River here, between Lakeville and Oakley, and that's going to continue to roll its way toward Royalton and Route 7. So if you're in these areas of southern Magoffin County, you need to be in a safe shelter immediately. That tornado warning just updating. Let me see if I can get in on some new data with that. That is for southern Magoffin County, and that tornado warning, this is now a confirmed tornado moving to the east at 25 miles per hour. So National Weather Service now saying this is a confirmed tornado near Hendricks, just to the south of Salyersville, moving to the east at 25 miles per hour. So not only are we looking at a radar-indicated tornado, but now we've got confirmation of a tornado that is moving its way across southern Magoffin County. That will make its way to the east very quickly and be on top of Royalton in just a matter of minutes. So we're looking at this storm moving to the east quickly at around 25 miles an hour. Up close and personal on this storm. So here's Royalton. If you're on Oakley, if you're on Carver, that is where we're dealing with this likely tornado. This is a confirmed tornado that is making its way just to the east now of Route 30 in Magoffin County. That's going to cross to the south of on the southern edge of Lakeville Road, and it's going to head over toward Route 7. Oakley Creek, Carver, we're dealing with this, making its way quickly now toward Royalton. That is right on top of Route 7. This is just to the south of downtown Salyersville. Downtown Salyersville, we're likely getting in on large hail with this. Confirmed tornado based on the correlation coefficient drop with this, which is an indication that the radar may be picking up on some debris showing up with this storm. So if you're in southern Magoffin County right now, you folks need to be doing me a solid and getting into a storm shelter immediately. If you're in a mobile home, you want to get out of that right now. You do not want to be in a mobile home. If you got a neighbor that's that has a brick home or a sturdy structure, that's where you need to be. So we're looking at this confirmed tornado that would be heading toward Royalton. This is Route 7. That's the connector between Salyersville and Royalton, which is in the southern part of the county. Route 30 is the connector that goes from Salyersville to Jackson and Breathitt County. So this is now east. This is Hendricks. This is the 4-acre area. Here's where we had that confirmed tornado, and that is making its way just to the south of downtown Salyersville. So from Lakeville through the Mason area, Mason Creek, into Oakley, into Carver and Royalton, we need to be in our storm shelters immediately. So this was a severe thunderstorm warning that has now been replaced with this tornado warning, and it is heading toward Royalton and Route 7. And the path on this, if it keeps the trajectory that it's on, it's going to head toward Ivington on the Mountain Parkway connector. That's 114 between Salyersville and Prestonsburg, and that is going to cross over into the western part of Floyd County coming up within the next 10 to 15 minutes or so. But as of now, I'm looking at this and that's a strong rotation signal. That's not shocking. It's been a calling card from this particular storm. And it's also been the calling card where this storm sometimes cycles up and starts to spin just a little bit. And we've been getting that rotation from time to time, and it tightened back up here as it made its way into Magoffin County, in the southern part of Magoffin County. This warning, it goes until 5:15, so we got about 14 and a half minutes or so left on that. I suspect by the time we hit 5:15, that is out of Magoffin County and it is rolling its way into Floyd County. But we're going to continue to look inside. So what we're dealing with now is a storm that doesn't have quite the spin as what we were dealing with just a little bit ago back across the Route 30 area. This is where the weather service started to pick up on the rotation with this, and we started to see it as well. It was right on top of Hendricks, the Middle Fork area of Magoffin County, essentially, is what we were talking about with that. And now it is into Royalton, Carver, Oakley, and rolling to the east of Route 7. Now, once that gets to the east of Route 7, it's going to begin to impact 114, which would be the Mountain Parkway that goes between Salyersville and Prestonsburg. And by the time we get to about the 505, 507 mark of in just 5 or 6 minutes, the worst of this is going to be now entering western Floyd County, southwestern parts of Johnson County. And Paintsville, we're okay. Prestonsburg, we're likely okay. That is just to our north and northwest. Downtown Salyersville, tornado sirens are likely going here. Those sirens were put in place after the deadly or the devastating tornado we had back in March 3rd of 2012. This one is a little farther to the south of that with the track, and it is rolling its way through. But I'm looking at this, and the overall spin is not as prominent as what we had 5 minutes ago, certainly not 10 or 15 minutes ago. It has broadened out just enough. And this is over a fairly rural part of the county. This is into the southern part of the county. So if we're going to get reports from this, they may be slow to trickle in. Hopefully, nothing is coming of this. But when you have the Weather Service tagging this as a confirmed tornado, they were confirming that based on something that we call correlation coefficient, where the radar, it's just another way the radar can look inside a storm, not just to show the winds, but it was showing what may be a little bit of an uptick in the radar image showing what could have been some debris. We'll see. Hopefully that was not the case. But nonetheless, that is right on top of Royalton, and it is rolling its way toward the east. The spin with that is nowhere near as prominent as what we were dealing with just a matter of a few minutes ago. Tornado warning has been canceled. Good news there. So that spin that we were looking at has now flattened out. So again, if you're watching us here now into Magoffin County, into Floyd County and Johnson County, that tornado warning has now been canceled. But we're going to continue to watch the storms that are out there. Any of those storms in an instant is like what we were just seeing can begin to spin up very, very quickly. Guys, what we're going to do, we're going to continue to watch these storms. And we'll be checking down into Magoffin County to see if we had any damage, because this was tagged as a confirmed tornado across the Route 30 area of Magoffin County over toward Route 7. Chances are we may start to get some damage reports. Again, as I said, those are, you know, it's kind of in a more rural area, so it may take a little bit before any damage reports trickle in. But if we get any information, we'll break in and let you guys know immediately.
Thank you very much, and well done. And this is WKYT News at 5. We are going to show you some of the damage we've had today, some of the issues out there, as we take a look at some of the video coming out of Madison County this afternoon as those storms were rolling through. This is in Waco. That, of course, to the east of Richmond. So far, emergency officials in Madison County say there is no major damage reported from the storm today. The sheriff's office says they do have a report of a tree down in northern Madison County, and that's pretty much all they've heard of at this point.
And we're also getting some power outage reports in Rockcastle County. Jackson Energy is reporting about 2,500 customers without power there. Storms went through and impacted the Broadhead substations. Crews are working to get the power on as quickly as possible. And remember, you can stay weather aware with the First Alert Weather app. To download it, scan the QR code that you see there on your screen, or you can always search for it in the app or Google Play stores. And remember, with that app, you're going to get the latest weather alerts and radar. And even if you were to lose power, the app is still going to work with cellular data to keep you and your family in the know.
All right, a collision of events today. It's also primary election day, and there's less than an hour left now for Kentuckians to get out and cast their ballots. Polls will close at 6 p.m. local time.
WKYT's Jeremy Toms has been out in Fayette County checking on those polling locations, talking to voters about their election day experience.
As polls are nearing their close across the Commonwealth, we're hearing from voters and poll workers alike who say that this has been a smooth experience, but that's due in part a very low voter turnout this primary day. Mark Walden is a first-time election official serving at Frederick Douglass High School. He feels this is an important time in our history, so he wanted to take on more civic responsibility.
Sadly, I think we all know the country is a little bit divided right now, so I think it's more important than ever for everybody to get out and say what they're thinking, and this is the place to do it.
But many Kentuckians may not be sharing that view this election day. Secretary of State Michael Adams anticipated overall turnout may be as low as 10%, with absentee ballot requests also down by 40%. Here at Frederick Douglass, they had seen less than 150 voters through the first 6 hours. But these poll workers and voters alike agree, even with the bad weather, and even if you may have a reason not to vote, getting out to cast your ballot is your chance to affect change and make your voice heard.
I'm driving to North Carolina today, and I'm an hour late, but I wanted to vote because I think it's very important to do so. If you want people to respect your opinions, it's important to vote to show that you care.
Well, those people that don't vote in the primaries are letting other people kind of dictate who we get to vote for, so I wish more people would vote in the primaries.
Just remember, as long as you are in line by 6 p.m. tonight, you will be able to cast your ballot. But don't forget to bring a photo ID. In Lexington, Jeremy Tom.